About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening and welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host, and this evening for our Christmas program, we have two large breeds. They are dogs that would easily be able to pull Santa's sleigh. So our guests are Carol Gehret, and she has the Greater Swiss Mountain Dog on my left, the black one, and the white one is Sharon Merkel, and she has a Great Pyrenees. So we have one of each color, both of them big, one hairy, one not so hairy. And I think we'll talk to Sharon first about her peers. Suppose you tell us what a Great Pyrenees is.
Great Pyrenees is a Pyrenean mountain dog, and they're mainly bred to guard livestock.
Oh, okay.
And, in France, in the Pyrenees Mountains.
Oh,
and okay. Actually, in the United States, they use them as guardian dogs. This one is not a guardian dog. This is just a pet. But
they, no herd of sheep, huh?
They are guardian dogs, and what they do is they'll go out and guard the perimeter of your property and keep anything out.
Okay. Either. So then, in the mountains, they were just left loose to live with the sheep.
They live with the sheep.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Or whatever livestock, and they're really, really independent, and they like to think for themselves.
Okay.
Which makes them hard to train for us because they think that they know better. So,
of course.
But that's because that's what they're bred to work on their own. Or they work in pairs.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
And one will be awake and one will be asleep, and they kind of tag team.
Okay. Well, yeah, I guess being out there by themselves, they would have to decide. Now, do they do any herding, or do they just keep the sheep in?
No, they don't herd. They just guard against predators. And,
okay.
My neighbor has sheep and goats, and they have three of them.
Mm-hmm.
Guard them. So
wow.
And they don't herd. That's
right.
Up to the border collies.
Okay. I just didn't know. You know, when the sheep herder put them out there, if they were out there for a month or 6 months,
they live with them. They're not really the ones that are the guardian dogs. The livestock guardian dogs are not. They don't keep them in the house at all.
Oh, okay.
And they'll live in a barn.
Always with the livestock.
Or they'll live out in the field with them, and they're not really what they wouldn't be considered pets.
Okay. Just strictly working dogs.
But then,
you know, in the olden days, there were no such thing as pets. You know, they were all working dogs.
Right.
They all had a job to do.
Right.
So these guys originated then.
They came from France.
Okay.
And it's a really, really old breed.
Okay.
And in the United States, we still use them as guardian dogs, mm-hmm. or show dogs, obedience dogs, whatever.
So now that you told us that they were hard to train.
They are hard to train.
So they can, as far as being house dogs, are they easy to housebreak?
I find this is a girl, and I've always found that the girls are a little harder to housebreak,
mm-hmm.
but they're really intelligent, they're really clean.
Okay.
And once they're housebroken, this is the only dog that I've had that will ring the bell on my door.
Okay.
If she has to go out, which
uh-huh.
surprised me because I've had that bell forever, and I have a lot of dogs, and nobody quite got that. And she, at 15 months, is like, I think I have to go out. So they're pretty smart.
Uh-huh.
It's just that they're stubborn, and you have to figure out it has to be their idea.
Yes.
Because it's like a horse. If she wants to go, if I want her in the car and she doesn't want to go up the ramp, she's just going to stay
there. Yeah, because it's, right, it's a lot of dog to lift. How much does she weigh?
She's 77 pounds.
Oh, okay.
And my other dog was a female, and she was about 86 at her heaviest. But the males, she has a brother that's... Kylie. She has a brother that's over 100 pounds.
Okay.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, that's a lot to lift. 70, you could probably...
70,
shush,
yeah.
You know, but 100 pounds is... Yeah, and if they're bound and determined they're not going to move, there's no way you're going to get them to move.
It's like a horse.
That's exactly right.
It's like a horse. And they'll just... And I've tried to drag her and, you know, but... When she's trained to do something like go in your kennel to
uh-huh.
eat,
uh-huh.
I'll say kennel, and she'll just dart across the house and go into the kennel to eat. So,
right.
You know, they're trainable, but you have to be very, very patient.
Uh-huh.
And, you know.
And lots of rewards.
And lots of rewards, and they get tired of particular rewards. So they might like a particular snack in the beginning of the training class, and by the end, they're like, I don't think I like that anymore. Do I have something else?
Oh, my word.
So
yeah,
I always have like four or five different bags of different things to see what she likes.
So now, do they come in different colors, or is this?
They're always white, or this is a badger-marked one. And which means that they have the badger markings on their face and black ears.
Okay.
But one of the questions we always laugh at, the Pyrenees people laugh at, people will say to them, I didn't know they came in white, and they think they're Newfoundlands. And we have to say, it's a different breed. I think people ask me that, I didn't know they came in white.
Oh, my word.
And people are not really used to the badger color, so they actually think, is that a rescue? But there's a lot of them with color out there now, and I kind of like it because it just masks their face.
I do, too. It just gives them so much more expression.
Right.
How popular actually is this breed?
It's not super popular because they're so large, but there's our clubs. Penn Dutch has a club, a local club. Doesn't have a lot of people in it, but the problem with the Great Pyrenees is people get them and they're small and they're really cute, and then they get this big and then they end up in rescue a lot of times because people don't know what to do with them.
Aww.
And they do like to bark. So if you're in an apartment, they don't need a lot of exercise. You don't have to take them. I take them for a walk every day, but it's not a dog that you're going to go out in your backyard with a ball and throw it at a Great Pyrenees because they're just going to watch it go and it's going to be gone. But they don't need a lot of exercise, but they like to be outside, but they will bark because they were bred to guard.
Yes.
So, she'll go around and bark for maybe 20 minutes before she stops.
Oh, my word.
And then, she's guarding her yard.
Huh. Even if there's nothing around, just to let the world know that she's there?
And they may know there might be something there. I don't know. I live in the woods, so and I have pigeons, so I always put her in the back and tell her, go guard the pigeons.
Yeah. You poor thing, pigeon.
Well, she got the pigeon once in her mouth, but she did hurt it. She just was like, she thought it was a toy. So.
Oh, wow.
And so I just got it out and put it away, and she's like, okay.
Yeah. Now, obviously, grooming is a big deal.
If you have a Great Pyrenees and you have a yard that has leaves in it, every time they come in you have to brush them because they'll bring everything in the yard in with them. Mm-hmm. So you get really used to having a brush in the doorway, on the way in the house, because they will bring it in and it'll be all over your house.
Yeah.
Because it's just the nature of the dog. So so is it formal grooming? No. Am I do I groom for show? No. But I have to brush her every time she comes in.
Okay. So then that's at least two or three times a day.
Oh, easily. Easily. Sometimes I'll put her on the front porch because there are no leaves out there.
But if she wouldn't be going out and getting leaves, in the summertime, do you still require daily brushing?
Yeah, because it's the fenced-in area is fairly wild. It's like woods.
Okay,
so she's picking up everything that's out there anyway. So.
But if you had a dog in the city?
You wouldn't have to brush it as much.
Okay.
But, if you have a dog like this in the city, you better hope that your neighbors don't mind barking because they will bark. Because it's a guard dog, and which is why I got it. Yeah. I wanted a guard dog. So, I wanted it
right.
to alert me.
Yeah, it's definitely going to protect you. I just didn't know if it was raised in the city, you wouldn't have that big a problem because the dog would have grown up from puppy on up.
It depends on the dog because my one right before her rarely barked at all.
Oh,
she was quiet until she got to be 10 years old.
Oh, wow.
But this one is a little loud. But they're all different.
Yeah.
Everyone
so
is different.
How long do these guys live?
Well, I have a friend who just lost one at 14.
Oh, my word.
So it's not they're going to die at 8, but it's a crapshoot, really. I mean, you don't know how long a dog is going to live. Generally, the bigger dogs live less.
Right, but that's surprising.
But that's 14, surprising, and he just couldn't walk well. And she had another one that was 13. So
that's really amazing.
So there is longevity. Not 18, but it just depends.
Right. Well, even the medium-sized dogs don't go to 18.
Right.
Would this dog be good with children?
They're really good with children. They're good with just about everything.
Now
she's a puppy, so if a young child came in, she might get playful with them. And she's playful she'll chase little baby animals, and I always say, you're supposed to be guarding them, not chasing them, but she's a puppy.
Right.
But they're generally good with it.
Well, how old
is
she?
She's 15 months.
15 months.
So okay. She's just a baby.
Yeah, she is just a baby.
Yeah.
So she's not going to get too much larger, though. I mean, as far as tall, she'll get
I think she'll drop her chest probably, yeah. And mm-hmm. you know, at two.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't think she's going to get much bigger. Yeah. She might be the size of Tansy. No, you're not going to play.
That's all we need.
That's all we need.
Max in between. Yeah. Health problems on these guys. Do they have a lot of hip problems or?
No, if they're bred well, they don't have a lot of problems. Okay. Are there ones in rescue that have hip problems? Maybe, mm-hmm. But they're pretty healthy. My other one was pretty healthy.
Yeah, I just didn't know about the hips because it is a large breed.
That's really, I think, in the breeding, you know, if it has bad hips, whether it's a lab or it's a Great Pyrenees. I mean, it's a big dog. You could tear the cruciate if it's playing
right,
wild.
Right, sure.
If they slide in the, you know, I'm always careful. I have a ramp to get her in and out of the car. Mm-hmm, I don't let her jump up. And
what was that about jumping up? Yeah.
Well, no, a Pyrenees, here's what a Pyrenees will do. They will stand on their back feet like a bear.
Uh-huh.
So, like, my border collies will run and jump and hit me. She will actually stand up. And she's not as good as it at my other one, but she would just stand up like a bear. And they're real light against you.
Wow.
So they almost stand on their back feet.
Yeah, yeah.
But she's not quite as, you know, she's a little wild child. You're wild.
Well, yes. Okay, let's talk to Carol then and find out about her Swissy, who happens to be totally in love with the Pyrenees.
Yes.
He just thinks she's the greatest thing. But now, he's not as old as she is, right?
He'll be a year old the night before Christmas.
Oh, okay.
He was born the night before Christmas.
Oh,
yes.
Wow.
Yes.
Some kind of Christmas present, right?
Oh, yes. We were very busy the night before Christmas last year.
So then you bred him?
Yes, I did.
Okay,
yes.
Okay. So now, what is a Greater Swiss Mountain Dog?
They are, they come from Switzerland, and they were used to, actually, they hitched them up to a cart and to pull the milk into town. So they do a lot of carting, they love to pull. However, there are some Swissies that are doing nose work, and they have done some herding. They also do agility. We have some people doing agility.
Wow.
So they do a lot of things.
Yeah. Yeah, you wouldn't think that these guys would be that good at jumping because of, you know, the bulk.
Yes. Well, some of them are bulkier than others.
Uh-huh.
I think it depends on how you breed the dog. If you want something that perhaps is more agility type, that you would want to streamline, yes, and not have quite as much bone as Snowman has here.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah. So now, how popular is that? In this area, I know they're fairly popular, but generally, are they a popular breed?
Well, I hope that they're not, because I'm just one of the many breeders, and we really try to screen our boys and girls before we do breeding.
Mm-hmm.
We check their eyes, hips, elbows, and shoulders now to make sure that they are healthy, they have no degenerative joint disease, and they could be ready to be in someone's breeding program.
Uh-huh,
so that's
uh-huh.
very important, I think, as a breeder.
Yeah, yeah. But, I mean, as far as the general public,
yes.
I don't think the giant breeds are as popular, and especially, you know, everybody's going with the teeny little things, but they're just not as popular as the little guys because of the size.
Correct.
Do you want me to hold him while you attach yourself again?
Okay.
Oh, fooey. That's a good dog.
Okay, I think I'm attached.
Okay.
I'm sorry, your question one more time. Three times
in
the charm.
Right. In the general population, how popular are they?
I don't think that they're that popular.
Right.
I think because they're a larger breed, they don't like to do a lot of running, but they are a big breed. So if you have them in a tiny apartment, the tail goes, and pretty soon the vases are going. And they do need room. They're not real active, but these guys do chase balls a little bit.
Okay.
And they can be a little bit on the stubborn side. So, you know, you have to be ready for a large breed. And, you know, families need to know that when they're puppies, they're just wonderful. But when they start growing up and they're, this guy is probably close to 100 pounds and over, you know, they do need to be ready. So I always have my families come visit to see how large the Swissies are going to be before they get a puppy.
Yeah.
So, you know, they have to know that. So I don't think they're real popular.
Okay. So then these guys would be fine in an apartment other than, I mean, if you have a very simplistic apartment, you know, no lamps hanging from the ceiling.
Correct.
Kind of thing.
They're fine in apartments.
Okay. So then
there
no
are
markers.
Some Swissies that are actually in New York City.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Oh, again. Oh, my. Yes.
He keeps getting his nose stuck in her mic.
He's so nosy. There are some Swissies in New York City, I might add, and on Long Island, and they are in apartments, big apartments.
Uh-huh. Now, you can see that just right here, he's almost 100 pounds or over 100 pounds, and he's only 12 months old, not even 12 months old, and it's a lot of dog to handle. It's a lot of dog to handle.
Yes.
He's still a puppy, and he's still, you know, hello there, how are you kind of thing.
Yes.
But, yeah, so you got to be, if you have young children, especially like a three-year-old, the dog would knock them over.
Correct.
Not because they're mean, just because they don't even know their own bodies yet.
Correct, yes. But I find that if a family that has young children gets a puppy that... if it's properly trained, I think there's a lot less of that perhaps than when you get a dog that is this size.
Mm-hmm.
You purchase a dog that is this size and you have a three or four or five-year-old child.
Yeah, but, you know, it's just the nature of the beast. They're big.
They're big.
I'm assuming that they are great with kids.
They're wonderful with kids, and they love their family.
Okay.
They do love children.
Yeah. And I think a lot of the working breeds are that way. They were bred to take care of everything. You know, they were the babysitters.
Yes.
And actually, this breed was brought over by a doctor right here in the Sinking Spring area.
Yes, dentist.
Yeah.
Dr.
Irwin.
No. I can't think of his name. Isn't that terrible? Yes, but he was from Sinking Spring, and actually that is where I got to loving the breed. I saw the article in the Reading newspaper about the dentist that had started a breeding program, and I thought someday I'm going to have Greater Swiss Mountain Dogs, and it took a while, but
Wow. So... as far as grooming with these guys, they still have the double coat. So
they do have a double coat. They shed twice a year. I call them the wash and wear breed because I just wash them and they dry out on their own. There's no need to poof them up. Very simple. They're very simple to maintain grooming-wise.
As opposed to that, right?
As opposed to this.
3 hours later, you're still drying it, right?
I'm wearing the hair.
Yes. Well, even with a short coat. People say, it's a short-coated breed, so it probably doesn't shed. And it's like, you have
they
all
do.
Black clothing or, you know, right?
They do.
So, health problems with these guys.
Of course, you always could possibly have the hip issue. However, again, as a breeder, if you get your OFAs and you get your screenings on your hips, elbows, eyes, and shoulders, and they are clear, there's no reason why you can't breed them. Now, there's no guarantees, but if you don't do the clearances, there's more of a problem of having health issues like hips, elbows.
So OFA is?
Orthopedic Foundation of Animals.
Yes. And that is what certifies the hips.
Correct. And the shoulders.
And the shoulders.
Yes.
Okay.
Elbows
okay.
and eyes.
Okay.
You get a chick number.
Do they, as a large breed, since they are fast growing, and that would be the same with the peers, do they get the, like, osteochondritis, the growing pains?
Yes, they do.
Okay.
They do. Some of them do. Not all of them. I've had some that had.
Yeah, because a lot of people don't even understand. They think they're crippled, you know, because the dog can't walk, and it's not... anything to really, it's just that the bone is growing too fast and it's not not knitting together.
Right.
I'm not having a breed that has that problem.
Right.
Well, it's. I think it's similar to growing teenagers. My daughter had Oscar Schlatter's disease, which is the same thing.
Oh, really?
Yes, yes. It's growing pains, and it hurts.
Yeah.
But, yes, you have to recognize it. And,
So then what do they do for it? Do they just, do you medicate, or do you just let them go? Do you give them an aspirin? How do you treat something like that?
It depends. I, of course, let the dog rest, you know, if they can. You can give some supplements for the joints, and they can be bought, you know, like at Walmart.
Mm-hmm. Okay, okay. Like glucosamine.
Glucosamine, MSM, okay. And chondroitin, okay. That type of okay. thing, okay. Yes. For people.
Yeah.
You know, you can give it to your dogs,
okay.
too.
Okay,
And sometimes they'll just grow out of it. But I don't see it being a big problem. I just see it in the growing dogs, especially the large breeds,
yeah.
the
yeah.
Swissies.
Yeah. So then exercise with these guys, they don't need a lot of exercise? So
no.
Walk around the block would
correct.
Would be, okay.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Oh, so, and now talking about walking, you are going to be walking in a parade,
yes.
right?
Yes, yes.
I did remember.
Yes, the Good Neighbors Downingtown Christmas Parade is this Saturday, starts at 3 o'clock. And our Middle Atlantic Greater Swiss Mountain Dog will be joining in the parade.
Okay.
We have 20-plus Swissies, and we're going to have some surprises, and I think there might be a couple of little floats going on during the parade as we walk down, but it's going to be a lot of fun.
You mean
this
the dogs
Saturday.
Are going to be taking their... They're going to be pulling their
yes.
own displays?
Yes, they are. Yes, yes, yes.
Very good. That'll be interesting to
yes.
see.
Yeah.
And it starts at 3 o'clock, and it's in Downingtown.
That's correct.
Wow.
Yes.
Yeah, that should be fun to see. That
yep.
should be fun to
the
see.
Snowman will be there, and a lot of other Swissies will have a good time. Hope
now,
everybody comes.
These two are, even though they're not popular, we have a local club.
Yes, we do.
Yeah.
Yes,
so
we do.
It's really interesting that both breeds that aren't really popular, so to speak, have clubs that are right here in this area.
Correct. So. Yeah. The Middle Atlantic Greater Swiss Mountain Dog Club covers... Oh, Pennsylvania, Delaware, New York, Ohio, and then we also have a club down below us in the Washington, D.C., Virginia area called the Chesapeake and Potomac Greater Swiss Mountain Dog Club.
Mm-hmm.
So there are clubs up and down the East Coast, out west.
Right,
yeah.
right.
But we have a local
yeah,
club,
yeah,
a local
yeah,
regional
which
club.
Which is, I just find is very interesting.
Yes.
Now, why did you select this breed? And they're closely related to the Bernese Mountain Dog, right?
That's correct. They're both Swiss dogs, Swiss
okay.
Mountain
okay.
dogs.
But the Berners have the coat. The Berners
correct.
Have a lot of hair, like the Pyrenees, but they're black.
Correct.
I mean, Newfoundlands are black and right. hairy, and these guys are black and, you know.
Tricolor.
Right, but tricolor, yes. And they don't come in any other color, right?
They do come in blue and red, but they're not acknowledged by the American Kennel Club, or I should say our breed club.
Okay. Now, blue, that's just like a grayish color.
That's correct.
They call it blue,
yes.
but it's like a grayish color.
Yes, and the
but
reds.
I don't think I've ever seen a red.
Yeah. It's similar to the red Dobermans, that color.
Oh, wow.
Yes, yes. There are not that many around.
Yeah. And,
for
and
sure.
that's a recessive then?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So why did you select the breed? Just because you like the coloring? The
Actually, my ancestors on my father's side go back to Switzerland, and when I read the article
okay.
about Dr. Summons.
Summons, really?
Yes,
that,
Dr. Summons
exactly
in
right.
the Reading Eagle. Oh, goodness, it might have been in, I'm going to say, the 1980s. I really fell in love with the breed, and I said, one day, you know,
right.
I will have one. And,
right.
And the early... 2001,
okay.
I think, is when I got my first Swissie.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
absolutely, and I've been in love with the breed ever since.
Well, very good.
Yes.
I thank both of you ladies for being on the program. It was very informative.
Thank you for having us.
A little bit larger breed than I would want. You know, I like a big dog, but not quite that big a dog. So anyway, since this is our Christmas program, I wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year, and I will see you in 2018. Good night.
All About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.